This is Gino's first concert in 15 years. We're here at the Saban Theatre. It's going to be a sold-out house. And I've got the Roland console here, which I've used many times. And we're all jazzed about it.
In my life, I felt so self-assured.
I'm Ross Vannelli. I'm a producer. I'm an engineer. I do production for my brother, Gino Vannelli. I also represent him. I go on the road, do 35 to 40 dates a year, and that's what I do.
My name is Nick Moon. I'm an audio engineer, and I'm here recording Gino Vannelli's live performance at the Saban Theatre in Los Angeles.
My name is Matt Greco, and I am Gino's tour manager and monitor engineer. And I've been working with him for about a year now.
Gino's setup is typically an M480 at front of house. And since we're recording, we've got the R1000, two of them redundantly recording. And we've also got the M380 and then two 1608s that we use for the analog ins, stage snakes going to the console. And then we just introduced the M48 personal monitor mixer, which we're using with Reinhardt Mells, who's our drummer, and he absolutely loves it.
Plus, we'll have a Maddie box on stage with a breakout to a mobile truck, which we'll probably have another R1000 in the mobile truck. And the setup, a breeze.
Oh, in my life.
I explained the M480 this way, four words. Looks small, sounds big, because that's exactly what it is. When we did some shows last year, and I walked in with a small console, and they looked at that and go, what is that? I said, that's the Roland M480. I said, how does that sound? I said, wait until you hear the show. At the end of the show, they came to me and says, how much is that thing? That's the first question to me. It sounds amazing. There's a misconception a little bit. You figure, well, since it's so small, can it really sound that great? Yes, it sounds that great.
As great as computers are, you know, I still wouldn't record a show like this with a laptop and some interface with a FireWire hard drive and all that kind of stuff. I think that standalone units like this, for reliability's sake, and it's just simple to be able to walk in, arm all the tracks, hit record, and know that you don't have to check on it and anything like that. So I would put up the R1000 against anybody else making multi-track recorders these days.
Without your love.
The M380 workflow is really, really easy to use. Everything is right there, kind of at your fingertips. And especially having the sense on fader is huge, because once I hit sense on fader and I have each band member on each aux output, I'm able to just pull up their mix. I love it. It's definitely been one of the most simple boards for me to just kind of come to and just start working on right away.
Memories of love above the city lights.
The M48 really wasn't too much of a problem for me to get to know it. And Reinhardt Mells, who's our drummer, he picked up on it really easily and stuff. I gave him a quick explanation and everything was there, and he was able to use it and start going with it. It was definitely great for him to have it, because he's the one who's making the most adjustments and everything. And the rest of the guys, they're pretty, once their ears are set, you know, they're happy. Yeah, for this show, because it's a bit of a bigger production, we've got a couple of background singers that we're bringing in, and we've got another artist who's going to be playing guitar for the show. So yeah, we integrated a couple more M48s into the show.
Its uniqueness is that it's being recorded audio video for PBS. And they'll be using it for many years for pledge drives and stuff like that. You know, there's some weight behind it. There's a lot of people, a lot of crew you could probably see in the background.
Such an extra production it was really kind of a no-brainer for us to go towards, you know, integrating in a full V-Mixer system.
We're going to be doing PBS specials all across the U.S. We're eventually going to do Pittsburgh and Las Vegas and other PBS stations.
One of the reasons why I'm here recording it is because I'm going to be the one responsible for mixing and mastering it. So as soon as we get back home on Monday, we'll be looking at all the audio and starting to mix. And we'll be mixing in 5.1 and we'll be mixing in for stereo as well.
Being all on the same system is huge. Everything works seamlessly, no issues. Sound quality is great. We know what we're getting, and yeah, and it's a great system.
You know, and as a mastering engineer who owns, you know, $10,000 A to D converters, I feel like I have a little bit of weight to talk about what I think sounds really good. And the V-Mix system really gives us that opportunity to make it sound like a CD every time we show up somewhere. That's why from the day one, there was no going back once we started using the V-Mix system. We don't feel like we're losing anything. If anything, we feel like we're gaining something because we can maintain mixes and all that kind of stuff from show to show and from venue to venue.
Everywhere I go, people are really impressed. Once they see it, they're intrigued. Once they hear it, they're sold.
Thank you.